Swami Vivekananda was following Ramakrishna. Ramakrishna was not a person who will be acceptable to other people because he always cries. Sometimes he will jump into the compound wall of the neighbor. He will be hugging the tree and he will be crying. And Ramakrishna identified Swami Vivekananda that he is the best person to understand what I am speaking. So he was an ardent follower of Ramakrishna, Swami Vivekananda. He didn't go for a job. Vivekananda didn't go for any job. He didn't complete his studies and all. He didn't take care of the family. His father was not there. His mother only was there. One day his mother became very sick. She was ailing and she is on the death bed. So Vivekananda comes to see mother and he was deeply pained because he realized that I have lost my life. I have lost my life. I didn't earn money. I didn't take care of my mother. I have no money to buy even medicines. We don't have food to eat. So what to do now? Mother is going to die. He was very emotional. Then he started scolding Ramakrishna. It is because of this person's wrong guidance that my life has been ruined by this person. He simply told me to realize God. All this God realization and all is useless because I have not led a very normal life. Mother is going to die. So he was annoyed and he went to Ramakrishna to quarrel with Ramakrishna. Why you deviated me from the normal life that I am suffering today? Ramakrishna found that this person is a little bit annoyed and he told that, what is your problem? My mother is ailing because of you only, because of your spiritual advice, God realization and all. I tried and I am of no use now. I cannot save my mother. Ramakrishna told that, don't worry. You pray to Goddess Kali, who is the mother of all. She will save your mother. And I have my puja room. You go to my puja room. You worship the Goddess Kali. She is the mother of all and she will take care of your mother. So Vivekananda went to the puja room and he was doing puja. He was, you know, worshipping Goddess Kali for 3 hours continuously. He came out. And Ramakrishna asked whether you prayed for your mother's good health. Vivekananda says, I forgot totally my mother. So Ramakrishna says, again you go to the puja room, you pray. At least now you pray for the good health of your mother. Now Vivekananda goes again to the puja room in front of Goddess Kali. He was sitting and he was doing puja. He was doing, he was worshipping this time for 8 hours. Then he came out of the puja room. Ramakrishna was asking, have you at least asked for the mother's good health now? And Vivekananda said, sorry, I forgot. Ramakrishna says, this is what is life. When you are involving in something, you have to forget everything. So that is what is the fundamental of success. When you are in devotion, you have to dissolve yourself in that devotion. Dissolving yourself in the devotion is what is the true happiness. If you had answered that, I prayed for my mother, this would be the last minute I am talking to you. Never ever in my life I will talk to you. I decided. And I know that you cannot recall your mother because you are a devotee. When a person is in devotion, he will dissolve in the devotion, and the devotion now for you is your preparation. If you can dissolve yourself in your preparation, when you can get disconnected from all friends, commitments, family, your own personal wishes, if you can dissolve yourself in the preparation, you believe that the most expected miracle will happen in your life. The miracle which you are desiring for is your number should be present in the list of successful candidates when the result is published by UPSC. So don't be influenced by others negatively. Dissolve in your preparation. Switch off your cell phone. Disconnect yourself from all the social media network. Seeing WhatsApp as well as studying is not going to help you. Some people, 5 minutes they'll study, 15 minutes they'll see the WhatsApp. Or 1 hour they'll study, 2 hours they'll see the WhatsApp. Or after 11 o'clock to 3 o'clock, simply they'll be chatting in the WhatsApp. These are the things which you have to avoid. Vivekananda forgot his own mother in the devotion. You forget all your pleasures, all your commitments in your preparation. That is the only way for you to crack this examination. And I assume that you have not seriously started your preparation. You can do wonders if you start right from today. Right? So, this is my takeaway. I am giving to you an important success strategy. Daily, 10 minutes you spend for this activity. All the troubles, the nuisance and all will have to be separated from you. Go to a calm place. Close your eyes. Visualize how success will be. For example, you close your eyes and you think that the prelims result is out. And you are checking your number in the website. Yes, your number is there. You clear your prelims, you write your mains, and you check your mains result, your number is there. You check your interview result, your name is there in the list of successful candidates. And in the front page itself, page number one itself, you have your name. Now, what is going to happen? All people will come to you to praise you. Those who cursed you, inclusive. Those who cursed you that you are fit for nothing, will see you as the new hero. All media will run behind you to have a glimpse of you, to take an interview from you. Your school, your college, your institutions will give you a red carpet welcome. And you go to Mussoorie, you attend the first day training orientation, you come across 200 people in your batch, around 200 people in your batch, and the dream stops. So, what will happen, you know, when you can visualize the success, it will be very tasty. Success is always tasty. That is why those people who are successful, they are addicted to the taste of success. Therefore, after getting one success, they wanted the next one, the next one, the next one. They tried to update themselves. They tried to become more and more hardworking to get the taste of the success again and again. The main problem with most of us is that we have not tasted success so far. Many of us, I assume that we have not tasted success so far. So we have only came to know when people told that this is how I felt when I saw my number or the name in the UPSC website. We were like blind men seeing the elephant. We have to open our eyes and see. We should be the one who will have to experience directly what success is. So, do this positive training of your mind every day, 5 to 10 minutes, without any disturbance. You will feel recharged. That positive vibration will attract a positive vibration and you will prepare properly. At the same time, if you have a negative thought, then I told you, subconscious mind will definitely accept that negative thought, and it will think that you wanted only the negative thing to happen, and it will support that negative thing. What do you think positively? The entire universe will act to make you realize that positive dream come true. If you think negatively, the entire universe will act in that way to ensure that what you dreamt, that you do it. So try to make use of your mind, because mind is everything. We have studied in the school days Alauddin and the magic lamp. If you rub the magic lamp, you'll get whatever you wanted. The magic lamp is your mind. You rub your mind with a positive thought, magic will happen. Right? So, this is what I wanted to tell to you now.